to everything we are talking about. In early 80s and middle, mid 80s, we had faculties, we had faculties in Aba. We are competing to make great parts in Indemi and Aba. We competed with Innocent's elder brother, this Gabros. We competed with him. These are competitions that are real. But today, can they still compete? Because there is no light. Our problem was Federation was where opera can go. He was going to what you call London with Barclays and can place sovereignty of Eastern Nigeria to borrow money at 0% with Barclays Bank. I'm not sure people who enter into leadership are not thinking about production. You cannot sustain this economy for this youth, even youth, without production. Unless we produce, unless we go back to our agriculture, we produce, cultivate, produce, and process. We cannot be a better nation. We can try everything we want to do. We have to go back to production. And production is the key. In Malaysia, I've been with a former prime minister many years. In China, Chairman Guo took agriculture from cultivating, feeding the people first. From cultivating, feeding the people, you go to export of raw materials, and he went back to process. And today, China is the warehouse of every country in the world. Malaysia is also a semi warehouse for all the countries. Nobody depends on petroleum. Petroleum is a cost to Nigeria. Petroleum is not a good thing for me and you, the youth. Petroleum makes us not to work hard. Petroleum makes us to think everything is easy. There's no easy way. People just saw tomorrow, yesterday, what the car has come up. No, I was a very successful person. I would be chairman of Cooperative and Commerce Bank. I was in the board of First Bank as a youth. I was in the board of One Man Bank. I was in the board of Unipetrol that we call our today. I was on board of the university in Bauchi. I was board in the polytechnic in Bauchi. I mean, if youth can come up and do what they're supposed to be, we don't need to find youth on the road. Today, right up to this, if you want to demonstrate, this is your right. But demonstration must be civilized. It must be a demonstration that the police will guide you, you guide the police, and you carry your plate card. No. Demonstration to go and destroy what you place, destroy houses, destroy investment of fellow Nigerians. It is not, it's unethical to be used and destroy these things. That is not possible. For me, my advice to you youth, today, turn around, get people to mentor you, like Dr. Ozochukwu and the wife are doing today. Go to Biosign, go to Dr. Cosmos, go to Pastor Tommy. These people, Professor Soludo, these people can mentor you. In fact, people like Professor Soludo, they never knew the blueprint he carelessly gave to me when I was a private businessman in Enugu. So, you see, maybe the youth goes today for money. They don't go to be listened to. We were mentored by people like Professor Jibril Adin, who supposed to have fought against me, but this guy knew what we stood for. What we stood for might not be right at that time, but it was right in our own eyes. So, I want you people to get back to their elders. Your elders will be able to mentor you. Practical example, none of these people, Soludo was a professor less than 30 years, but Tommy was managing director of Oxygen of Nigeria after 2 years. So what is youth? Youth is for you people to come under one boat. So we can make our country beautiful. Youth is not the carrying class of people who feel disgusted. I have not seen anybody. President Gowon was a youth when he took over. President Buhari was a youth for the first time he became president. President Babangida was a youth on the Second, the first time he became president. What promises are youth? So let's come together with our youth and do what is there is doing. Come to us, we'll go to you. He came to us, we are mentoring him today. What he comes to us to do is to learn. Find one or two people in your villages, in your areas, to mentor you and give you the proper direction. Thank you very much. And God bless the youth of Nigeria. Thank you very much.
Please celebrate His Excellency with another round of applause. Ladies and gentlemen, if you